In this video, I'll be showing you how to insert rows and columns. Looking at the example on your screen, let's assume we want to insert a new column between D and E, and we're going to add some figures for April. So what we'll do is we will right-click on the column letter that we wish were blank. I wish column E were blank so that I could insert April. So right-click on the E and choose Insert. That scoots over the total column, and you can go ahead and type in your expenses for April. If you wanted to insert more than one column, you could highlight more than one. So let's say that I want to add, for some reason, two columns in this space. Highlight them both, right-click, and insert. And notice how, I'll scroll over here, notice how two columns were inserted. To delete a column, you right-click and choose Delete. If you want to delete more than one column, highlight them all, right-click, and delete. Now, you can insert and delete rows in exactly the same way. Let's say that in the row 8, I would like to add another expense for the internet. So just like in the column, I right-clicked on the letter of the column that I wish were blank. I'm going to right-click on row 8 and choose Insert. I can then type in the new category, and of course I can plug the figures in. The same theory, if you want to insert several rows, let's say I want some extra rows at the top. In fact, I want three of them. Highlight three rows, right-click, and insert. See how you inserted three rows? Now you can get rid of rows in the same way. You can right-click and delete. If you want to get rid of more than one row at a time, select them both, right-click, and delete. And I'll get rid of row 8. So that's how you insert and remove columns and rows. This is the end of the video.